بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ما يهده الله فلا مضل له وما يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد فحياكم الله أيها الإخوة والأخوات حياكم الله وآواكم حياكم الله وبياكم حياكم الله ونصركم وطبتم وطاب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا وأسأل الله تعالى الذي جمعنا في هذا المكان المبارك على طاعته أن يجمعنا تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ظل إلا ظله أيها الإخوة والأخوات لقد تحدى الله سبحانه وتعالى الأمة بكاملها ملوكها ورؤوسها ورؤسائها كبارها وصغارها تحداهم في سورة آل عمران فادرؤوا عن أنفسكم الموت إن كنتم صادقين وهذا التحدي قائم إلى قيام الساعة فادرؤوا عن أنفسكم الموت إن كنتم صادقين ويقول سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الواقعة فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين كل نفس ذائقة الموت My brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has challenged the entire mankind, ins and jinn. And this challenge is open until the end of time. Allah azza wa jal has challenged the kings and the leaders, men and women, black and white, all kinds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran verse number 168, فَادْرَأُوا عَنْ أَنْفُسِكُمُ الْمَوْتَ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ Avert death upon you if you're truthful. Can you avert death upon you? Can you ward off from death? Can you run away from death? Can you escape death? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Waqi'ah verse number 86 and 87, فَلَوْلَا إِنْ كُنْتُمْ غَيْرَ مَدِينِينَ تَرْجِعُونَهَا إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ ارجعونها. Can you bring back your soul? Can anybody bring back their soul? Can you bring back and make up the salah which you have missed? Once you're dead, can you in fact tell the angel of death, can you come back? I want to repent. Nobody can. You cannot avert death. You cannot tell the angel of death to come back and to give you a chance. And this is the challenge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put forth until the end of time. Do you know how your end would be? Does any one of us know how their end would be? None of us know how our khatima would be. A man in the day of judgment, as the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a man will be or will get resurrected upon the same way he died. If he died making sujood, he'd be resurrected making sujood. If he died saying, Ya labbaik Allahumma labbaik, he would be resurrected saying, Labbaik Allahumma labbaik. If he died drunk, he'd be resurrected drunk. None of us know how the end would be. And this is the truth. This is the truth. The angel of death does not care how old you are. You don't have to wait until you're gray or your beard statue and some gray hair, because the angel of death really does not care how old you are, because when your time is up, your time is up. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul shall taste death. And this is the truth. Even Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the most beloved man in the sight of Allah, has tasted from this cup called death. He drank from it sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. Say, in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, Allah says, say that death that you're trying to escape from, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. It shall meet you. It shall get you. وَلَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُرُوجٍ مُشَيَّدَةٍ. Even if you are in these fortresses trying to hide from death, yes, you can run, but you cannot hide. And this is the truth. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. حتى إذا بلغت التراقي وقيل من راق وظن أنه الفراق والتفت الساق بالساق إلى ربك يومئذ المساء. كلا. Nay. كلا. When the death reaches the collarbone, and a man would say, لا ربي رجعون. Oh Allah, bring me back. Can you come back? No, you cannot. كلا. When حتى إذا صفر وجهك ولا تستطيع الحركة وتنظر إلى يمينك وإلى شمالك. When your face will become yellow. When your body will become cold, blue. You can't move. You are dying. You look onto your right and you look onto your left. You see your children, you see your family. You say, help me, but they cannot help you. كلا إذا بلغت التراقي وقيل من راق. You will say that day, who can give me رقية؟ من راق. وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق ذلك ما كنت منه تحيد. And the intoxication of death, the stupor of death, the pain of death has come with the truth. And what is the truth? The truth is you and I will die. And that is the truth. كلا جاءت سكرة الموت. When the stupor of death has come with the truth, بالحق. الحق, the truth. And what is the truth? The truth is you shall see the angels of Rahmah, or you may see the other angels. This is the truth. You look right, left, your children, your spouse, none can help you. And the Prophet beautifully explained this in hadith. I'd like to share with you this hadith. And I'd like to live this hadith. Because you and I, all of us, will have to go to this journey. Journey to the hereafter. The Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, والحديث أخرجه الحاكم في المسدرك والإمام أحمد في المسند والبيهقي في السنن من حديث البراء بن عازب قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن المؤمن إذا أقبل. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, when the mu'min, now we're going to talk about the believers, when the mu'min, he is in his final breath, خلاص, he's dying. أتته ملائكة بيض الوجوه. Angels will come. Angels will come. Bright faces, beautiful angels. بيض الوجوه, طيب الريح, with beautiful smell. Carrying with them a shroud from the heavens with beautiful smell. And they will come. فيجلسون منه مد البصر. They will come and sit as far as the eye can see from the person who's dying. And they will sit and wait. فيأتيه ملك الموت. And the angel of death will come. The angel of death will come and he will say, فَيَجْلِسُ مِنْهُ ثُمَّ يَقُولُ لَهُ. And the angel of death will say, يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الطَّيِّبَةُ أُخْرُجِي إِلَىٰ رَبٍ رَاضٍ غَيْرِ غَضْبَانٍ اخرجي الى مغفرة من الله ورضوان ورب راض غير غضبان. The angel of death will come and he will say, oh you beautiful soul, come out to a well-pleasing Lord. Come out to a well-pleasing Lord. And the soul فتخرج الروح. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, he says, فَتَسِيلُ الْرُوحُ كَمَا تَسِيلُ الْقَطْرَةُ مِنْ فَيْءِ السِّقَاءِ. And the Prophet says, the soul shall come out just like the last drop comes out from a bottle of water. You see, when you have a bottle of water, and then you pour that water, the water comes out so strongly, but you have that last drop at the very end, the last drop comes out very smoothly, very softly. That's how the soul will come out. As soon as the soul comes out, those angels who've been sitting and waiting, they run and they will take the soul. They will not let the angel of death take the soul. They will take it, they will fold it on that shroud from heaven, and then they will take it into the heavens. فيستفتحون. They will go into the first heaven. فيستفتحون. فيقول من؟ يقال فلان ابن فلان. بأحب الأسماء الذي كان ينادى عليها. They will say who? The first gatekeepers of heaven. They will say who? They will say فلان ابن فلان. So the son of so with the most beautiful names used to be called محمد ابن عبد الله. فاطمة بنت محمد. Whatever your name is, فلان ابن فلان. And the heavens will open up the first sky, and then they will go to the second, and the third, and the fourth, and the fifth, and the sixth, and the seventh. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, اُكْتُبُ كِتَابَ عَبْدِي فِي عِلِّيِّينَ. Write my slave amongst the عِلِّيِّينَ, the higher levels, and then bring him back into earth. اِرْجِعُوهُ إِلَى الْأَرْثِ. Bring him back to earth. فَمِنْهَا خَلَقْتُهُمْ وَإِلَيْهَا أُعِيدُهُمْ وَمِنْهَا أُخْرِجُهُمْ طَارَةً أُخْرَى. For from it we have created him, and from it we shall resurrect him. From it he shall come back, and from it he shall be resurrected. And his soul shall come back to where? The soul shall come back to the body. Now you are where? You are in the grave. Picture this. You are in the grave. The soul is in the body. You are in the grave. What happens? فَيَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَانِ فَيُجْلِسَانِهِ. Allah. Two angels will come, and they will sit by his head, and they will raise him, and they will ask him, مَنْ رَبُّكْ. They will ask him, who's your Lord? Three questions. You have heard of these questions, and you know the answers. Three questions. Question number one, مَنْ رَبُّكْ. Who is your Lord? فيخيل إليه. اسمع اسمع اسمع. فيخيل إليه أن الشمس تغرب فيقول دعوني أصلي. قلبه معلق بالصلاة حتى وهو ميت. As soon as they say, who is your Lord? He goes under the impression that the sun is setting. So he says, let me pray, let me pray. Let me pray, let me pray. He thinks it's khalas, salah time. Salah time, let me. His soul is connected to salah even when he's dead. Even dead, and he wants to pray. He says, let me pray, let me pray. They will say, you shall pray. Just tell us, who's your Lord? Man Rabbuk? He will say, Rabbi Allah. My Lord is Allah. Ma dinuk? What's your religion? Dini al-Islam. My religion is Islam. I lived in accordance with Islam. I loved Islam. Not only in the masjid, outside of the masjid. In my home, I lived Islam. In my business, I lived Islam. In the streets, I lived Islam. With my neighbors, I lived Islam. Everywhere, I lived Islam. Not only in the masjid. Dini al-Islam. Man dhalika ar-rajul alladhi bu'itha fikum? Who was that man that was sent to you? He will say, Nabiyyi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who is that man that was sent to you? He will say, my prophet is Muhammad. My prophet is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And a man will come to him in his grave. طيب الريح أبيض الوجه. A beautiful man with a bright face and beautiful smell will come. ثم يقول له أبشر
فذاك اليوم هذا اليوم الذي كنت توعد.
He says, glad tidings to you. This is the day which you've been promised. Glad tidings to you. The dead man will say, who are you? من أنت? Who are you? This beautiful face that comes with good news. Who are you? The man will say, أنا عملك الصالح. أنا عملك الصالح. The man shall say to you when he comes to you in your grave to accompany you, he will tell you, I am your righteous deed. I am your salah. I am your siyam. I am your qiyam. I am your obedience to your parents. I am the recitation of the Quran. You made me. I did not make you. Ana amaluka salih. I am your righteous deed. He will come to accompany you in your grave. And Allah Azza wa Jal will open up a window. And the man will say, he will see his place in Jannah. And he will say, Rabbi, aqim al-sa'ah. Rabbi, aqim al-sa'ah. Oh Allah, start the hour. Oh Allah, start the hour. I want to go to my place in Jannah. Our true place is not here. We're just travelers. We're nothing but travelers. Our true place is in Jannah. We were there. We got kicked out. We want to come back there, inshallah ta'ala, eventually. And this is how the journey starts, my dear brothers and sisters. Now, are you ready for that journey? That's the question. Am I ready to stand before Allah? Am I ready to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and sisters? The question again is, are you making tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Aina tawbah? Ya man asrafta ala nafsik. يا من تركت الصلاة يا من تركت الحجاب أين التوبة to those who have left the صلاة to those who don't pray to those who only pray in Jum'ah to those who don't pray صلاة الفجر to those who don't wear hijab only when they come to the masjid to those who lie to those who don't recite Quran to those who wrong themselves where is توبة when you're going to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't think I'm still young, it's too early. You do not know when you're going to depart from this life. So you only have one solution. And that solution is to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today before tomorrow. And you don't say, why should I repent? Why should I repent? I'm such a good man. I'm such a good woman. I pray. I just came back from Hajj. Why should I repent? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ جَمِيعًا And repent to Allah. All جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ He did not call the Muslims. He says the believers. You're believers. You should make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we all need to come back to Allah and repent to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, when you repent to Allah, you make Allah happy. Wallahi, you make Allah happy. You make Allah happy subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is awaiting us to repent to Him. Allah is awaiting us so He can forgive us, so He can accept our repentance. We sin, we are sinners. Allah loves to forgive because He is the unforgiver, subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ صَرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا جَمِيعًا Say, oh my servants who have transgressed against themselves. Say, oh my servants who has transgressed against themselves. Don't despair from the mercy of Allah. Allah forgives all the sins. For me, this is the most hopeful ayah in the Quran. Allah forgives all the sins. I committed zina. All the sins. I was bad to my parents. All the sins. All the sins. I deal with usury. All the sins. I'm telling you. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Zumar, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ صَرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ Who says that? The killer. Of the uncle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Wahshi, when he went to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, I want to become a Muslim. I want an ayah from the Quran whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises to forgive me. The Prophet tells him, become a Muslim. Allah forgives all the sins. He said, la. I want something specific. I want something specific. Allah revealed, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ Say, oh my servants who have transgressed against themselves, don't despair from the mercy of Allah. Allah forgives not one sin, not two sins. Allah forgives all the sins. We sin, forgives. We sin, we forgive.
He forgives, subhanAllah. Why? Because he is at-Tawwab, he is al-Ghafoor, he is al-Ghafar, he is al-Afu. He loves to forgive, subhanahu wa ta'ala. When this ayah was revealed, which I'm going to narrate now, Shaytan cried. وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهِ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Those who wrong themselves and then they remember you committed a sin and then you remember and you realize that you have committed a sin. So what do? You refrain from the sin and then you make istighfar to Allah. Allah says, and who is the one who forgives the sins other than Allah? Who is willing to forgive the sins other than Allah? You may go to a loved one, to a person, to a friend who you thought was a very good friend, a loved one, which maybe you have wronged, and you say, please, I've wronged you, I've done something wrong, forgive me. And that person refuses to forgive you. Allah will never refuse to forgive you as long as you come back to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Come to Him. Come to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have one last ayah to share with you, insha'Allah ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Just to show you the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reported by أهل السنة in this hadith. When Fir'aun got destroyed, you know, in the sea, Jibreel came. Fir'aun hasn't died yet. And Fir'aun hasn't died yet, so he was about to say, Allah, Allah, Amantu, I believe, Amantu. Jibreel took earth, mud, and started filling up Fir'aun's mouth. He was afraid that Fir'aun will say, La ilaha illallah. Allah revealed to Jibreel, oh Jibreel, by my majesty, if he was to say, La ilaha illallah, by my majesty, I will forgive him. Who is this? Allah forgiving who? The one who says, Ana rabbukumul a'la. Allah loves to forgive. Not only that, would you like my brothers and sisters, angels, special ones, special angels, who are in fact surrounding the throne of Allah, those who are carrying the throne of Allah, to make istighfar for you and for your loved ones, for your parents, for your children, for your spouses? This beautiful ayah in Surah Ghafir. In Surah Ghafir, verse number 7, 8, 9, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الذين يحملون العرش ومن فوقه يسبحون بحمد ربهم الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم ويؤمنون به ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم وقهم السيئات ومن تق السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and those who carry the throne, what are they doing? They're praising their Lord. They believe in their Lord and they're praising Him. And they're making istighfar to those who repent and they say, Rabbana, our Lord, wasi'at rahmatu kulla shay'in rahmata wa ilma. Our Lord, forgive those who have repented. Our Lord, forgive those who have repented
and bless them with Jannat Adn allati wa'adtahum. Oh Allah, bless them, not only them, bless them and their children and their spouses with the Jannat, the highest level of Jannat which you have promised them. Oh Allah, our Lord, and deprive them from committing sins. Deprive them, save them, ward them off from committing sins as those who you have deprived from committing sins are indeed the successful ones. My brothers and sisters, these are special angels making dua for you and I when we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have no other choice than to repent to Him today. Wallahi, you do not know who's waiting for you outside. In fact, after salah, we're going to pray salat al-janazah. And salat al-janazah is every day, every time. I just came back from Hajj, like the Shaykh was came back from Hajj. After every salah, they call salat al-janazah. Every day, every salah, every salah. Now, we can pray salat al-janazah on two people. Maybe, Allahu A'lam, tomorrow, it could be me there. It could be you there, praying salat al-janazah on you. So my brothers and sisters, repent today before tomorrow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Repent to Allah. Come back to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is between you and Allah, azza wa jal. Tawbu ila Allah. Aina dumu' al-tawbah? What are the tears of repentance? Because one of the signs of acceptance is that you show some tears before Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah accept our tawbah. May Allah accept your tawbah. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless your heart. May Allah bless your health. May Allah bless your wealth. May Allah put barakah in your time. May Allah put barakah in your wealth. May Allah protect you and protect your loved ones, inshallah ta'ala. May Allah grant you all the highest level in Jannah. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Wa'afina fi man afayt. وتولنا فيما توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا مريدا إلا شفيته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيته أرحم الراحمين اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام واجعلنا منهم ولا تخذل ولا تخذل من خذل دين محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام ولا تجعل أحدا من المسلمين منهم اللهم يا عزيز أعزنا اللهم يا كريم أكرمنا اللهم يا نصير انصرنا اللهم يا غفور اغفر لنا اللهم يا غفار اغفر لنا اللهم يا تواب تب علينا اللهم يا رحيم ارحمنا اللهم يا رحمن ارحمنا اللهم يا رحمن ارحمنا يا لطيف الطف بنا يا لطيف الطف بنا يا قوي قوينا يا شافي اشفي مرضانا يا شافي اشفي مرضانا يا شافي اشفي مرضانا اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم إن نسينا فلا ننسى والدينا اللهم اغفر لهم كما ربونا صغارا اللهم ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا أبوانا أبوانا اللهم الأحياء منهم اغفر لهم تجاوز عنهم اغفر لهم توب عليهم يا رب العالمين أكرمهم وأحسن إليهم والأموات منهم اغفر لهم تجاوز عنهم نور مدخلهم آنس وحشتهم آنس وحشتهم نقي من الخطايا كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس اغسل من الخطايا بالماء والثلج والبرد برحمتك أرحم الراحمين اللهم يا أرحم الراحمين يا مجيب استجيب لدعائنا يا مجيب استجيب لدعائنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا اللهم ارفع مقتك وغضبك عنا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين عباد الله ان الله يأمر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون واقم الصلاه